Thanksgiving, everybody! ACMI is proud to bring you the annual Turkey Day Classic. Your Arlington Spy Ponders take on their in-town rivals, the Arlington Catholic Cougars. My name is Scott Zwick, and as always, I'm alongside the professor, Rob Anthony. Happy Thanksgiving, Pards.
Happy Thanksgiving to you, Scott, and all our family and friends tuning in around the globe on YouTube and on ACMI.tv.
It's tradition and rivalry time, and the Spy Ponders come in riding high.
Spy Ponders are on a little bit of a roll after a tough season. They've got two straight wins, defeating Boston Latin last week. We will talk about that game. But they're in an unfamiliar position, Scott. The story up until now has been, how are they going to respond to losses? Today, what we're going to find out is, how will they respond to coming in on the back of a couple wins?
For AC, they've struggled to get wins, but can make all the bad go away with a single win today.
Don't sleep on the Cougars, says Coach Ryan Gendron. They've got some size. They got some speed. They have a one-man wrecking crew in running back Spencer Burton. They've played a tough schedule. It's been an injury year, most notably their quarterback Michael Burke. And as we know, Scott, a hungry Cougar is a dangerous Cougar.
It sure is. And, Rob, the Turkey Day Classic between these two teams began in 2008 with each team hoisting the winner's trophy four times each.
It's a rubber game of sorts, and it's been quite a series since this became the rivalry game. They're 4-4, as you say, Scott. Arlington Catholic won four out of the first five games, and Arlington comes into the game having won three in a row. So that kind of momentum can also build some more than excitement, build a little urgency, and that's what we're going to see today.
We certainly are going to see that today, and Rob, when we talked to Coach Gendron tonight, he spoke about, and both coaches, in fact, they really thought that this was going to be a tilt, an even tilt, a hard-fought tilt, close game right down to the end.
That's what we're looking forward to, Scott, certainly. And you can throw records out the window. Both teams are young teams. The Ponders, as we know, have a sophomore quarterback. The Cougars, as we know, have a junior quarterback and a lot of underclassmen on both sides of the ball for both teams. So the year's been a little bit of a learning experience. The Cougars play in a tough conference, and they've got a lot of, like I said, size. They have eight players over 240 pounds. The Ponders are a little bit undersized, so this ball game.
Sure is going to be a tough ball game. As you see out there, the captains are going over the instructions after the coin toss. I believe Arlington won the toss second half, so it would appear that they deferred and that the Arlington Catholic Cougars will get the ball to start the ball game, so they'll look to go fast. And, Rob, we know, overseeing Serge Clivio throughout the years, he's always got a trick or two up his sleeve.
Absolutely. Serge is a master, and he kind of lifts up the game for both teams. He has 2 weeks to prepare for the Thanksgiving game, and typically Serge Clivio teams come out on Thanksgiving, as we've seen year after year, very crisp, very creative, with a very definite plan for what they want to do, and most often they do it.
So we're going to take a minute here to pause and honor our country with our national anthem.
I've done this once or twice. Probably once.
bother me. And let's get ready to play some Turkey Day football. Bing, bang, boom. So, as Rob, you mentioned, the Spy Bonners come in on a two-game winning streak. The Cougars are 0-12, and as you mentioned before, sometimes one of the most dangerous teams is a team that doesn't have a win yet.
Absolutely. What we learned yesterday talking to Serge Clivio is that Serge Clivio has been with this team since 1984. Is that right, Scott?
That is right.
32 years. I believe that the year before 33, the Cougars went winless, and the Cougars are going to be very hungry for their first win and very capable of getting it.
So Sam Swift do the kicking for the Spy Ponders, and Cordell Parrish will be back deep to receive for the Cougars. It's kicked to Riley Donovan, who's wrapped up. A nice play by Matt Pickett right off the bat. And Rob, special teams have been a strength of the Spy Ponders all year long.
Spy Ponders have done a beautiful job on special teams and punt coverage and kickoff coverage, and that's what we saw there. It's a good way to start the game. And the battle is joined. It's about 35 degrees here at game time. Nice and crisp, and players are going to feel those hits.
So it's an empty set for Michael Burke on first down. Scrambling around, looking for a receiver. Now he's going to run. He tucks his run, gets a nice little gain over to the left-hand side, and there's Michael Burke showing his versatility early.
Yeah, Michael Burke was very creative on that play. Didn't have anything, and the Spy Ponders just really couldn't get to him. So did a nice job kind of tucking in and getting 5 yards on first down, which is what they want to do.
So it brings up a second and five for the Cougars. Again, an empty set. Three to the top of your screen, two to the bottom. In motion goes Cordell Parrish. And he slammed to the ground with bad intent that time by Ben Jacy with help from friends. Brings up a third and five, and they'll go quick.
Clearly jacked and pumped for this one.
So jacked and pumped, they almost stepped off sides, but they got back on side. Here's Burke. He's going to run for it. Escapes a tackle. Gets out of the box. Is belted out of bounds at about the 27. And that's going to force an Arlington Catholic punt. And it's three and out for the Cougars.
A lot of tackles that time. Left tackle for the Cougars, Justin Smith, took down Leonardo Maniti as well on that play. But the punter still prevailed. And they're going to get their first crack at the football.
So back to return for the Spy Ponders is junior Elijah Woods. Doing the punting for the Cougars is Seamus Holden.
Woods setting up about 30 yards downfield.
He didn't call for a fair catch. They throw a flag on the play. The ball is returned to about the 30. That time by number 66, John Bowen. And that play will grow in lore as the years go by.
Elijah Woods feels his first contact to the ball game. You know, I think the helmet of the defender hit before the football. We're going to see it again here. Not a bad punt. Woods does not call for the fair catch. The ball and the hat arrive simultaneously. I think that was probably a good call.
It's a good call. You have to give him space. He didn't call for a fair catch, but you still have to give the receiver room to catch the football. And that's going to be, I believe that's a 15-yard penalty. And that's just what Stripes will march off there. Very methodical Stripes early.
They were talking about it. They were making sure they got that one right.
They sure were making sure they got that one right. And so it'll be a first and 10. The Spy Ponders have great field position at the 49 of the Cougars. And that's where Bowler will take over. Nascimento, the deep back, on a first and 10. Scoreless on a Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to you and yours from us at ACMI. Bowler on that seam route that he's like to use. Incomplete. Intended for my man, Michael Doherty.
Coach Gendron and the Ponders come out swinging, trying to go over the top on the very first play of the ballgame. You know, sometimes when good things happen, either you recover a fumble or you get a nice penalty, you begin in the other guy's territory. You want to try to strike quick, and that's what the Ponders took their strike but didn't quite get there.
So that brings up second and 10. They'd like to use a little jet sweep here oftentimes to see if that's what they go to. And here's that jet sweep, and that's just what they do. They hand it off to Elijah Woods over the left-hand side. He's wrapped up by a couple of angry, hungry Cougars, and he gets a gain of about one. That's going to bring up third and 9. Rob, the Spy Ponders struggled all year long with third and longs.
Third and long is not what you want to see on a 35-degree day when you're still getting used to the football field. You've watched this team before, Scott. You called that jet sweep.
Yeah, we've seen that a lot this year, and they've had a lot of success, quite frankly, with Pickett running it and with Elijah Woods after the emergence of Nascimento in the second half. Third and 10. Here's Bowler going left and 10 for Pickett. It's incomplete, and Bowler threw a little high. He sets the success here, thrown to his left side. I had some struggles thrown to the left-hand side.
Yeah, that one was a little bit high. He really fired the ball, got a lot on it, but it sailed a little bit, and the Ponders are going to give the ball back up on Turkey Day.
So a little tit-for-tat there. The Spy Ponders give back the ball to the Cougars after their own three and out. And that looked like a little offsides there on Arlington Catholic. No, they're going to say it's going to be a false start. And so that'll march the Spy Ponders back 5 yards. And so that means that sophomore Sam Swift will punt from about his 35. And Cordell Parrish is down at his 20 to receive. It's a little deep. Yeah, way too deep, Cordell. You got to move yourself up about 20 yards there. It's picked up by Cully Curran, and that's where the Cougars will take over first and 10 from their own, looks like, 31-yard line.
Swift has had a good year punting. Again, weather probably a little bit of a factor. That ball is going to be very hard, and it's going to be hard to get off a boomer in this game.
Frigid conditions here at Pierce Field. I got my gloves on today, and there is Burke over the left-hand side. Michael Thielbar in on the tackle, and Rob Thielbar's been everything for the Spy Ponders on both sides of the ball.
Thielbar's had a very big year, and so has Big Ben Jacy. They've really controlled the middle of the field. That's what they're going to need to do today.
So Parrish the deep back on a second and 11. They give it to him. That time he goes nowhere. Cully Curran wraps him up for a big loss.
Cully Curran that time saying, no, 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 you're going nowhere. Stay down for a while. The Ponders are getting tremendous penetration early. They've been living in the backfield of the Cougars. And third and long, this is a tough down and distance.
Third and 15 to be exact. Burke looks like a little screen is set up here. That's exactly what it was. The pass was intended for Spencer Burton, but he couldn't handle it. It'll bring up fourth down and another punt for the Arlington Catholic Cougars.
Ponders really read the screen well sometime. Even if that was caught, that was really going nowhere. So a battle of field position early, and Ponders have a pretty good chance of setting up again right near midfield.
So Spencer Burton will punt for the Spy Ponders, who have Elijah Woods back. And Elijah, you're way too far back yourself. Maybe he wasn't. It's a good punt. Burton's got a leg, but Woods has a little bit of a lane here. He spins, zigzags, and even zooms himself up to the 42, and that's where the Spy Ponders will take over first and 10 with 7:33 left in the first quarter.
Elijah Woods doing a tremendous job this year all year long on punt returns and on kickoff returns. He's really built for that role. He can he knows when to kind of put his head down and rumble and when to do a little jitterbug. That time it was the more put your head down and rumble, and he got the ball over midfield.
So first and 10 for the Spy Ponders. Ball is actually at the 45. This time Elijah Woods is the deep back. Super sophomore Jaden Dotton is in the slot. Little pitch and a little catch right there. Zigging and zagging and zooming.
It's Cully Curran.
That's actually Cully Curran, super junior Cully Curran. And Cully Curran with a nice little pitch and catch and first down.
You know, it's no coincidence, Scott, that this team came around and started to put points on the board and win ball games when Cully Curran, who spent a lot of the year injured, came back into the lineup. He's really added a spark to this team.
Second and four for the Spy Ponders. Bowler keeps the ball. Blitzed by the Cougars, picked up well by the Spy Ponders, and Bowler comes close to first down. We'll see if they move those sticks. I don't see him moving yet. It's going to be a little bit short, setting up a third and one for the Spy Ponders.
Yeah, the Cougars bring in two guys on the blitz, and it was successful that time, and Bowler actually fumbled the ball after he hit the ground. Good call by Stripes, but it was a little bit of a close call.
Was a little bit of a close call. Third and one, the playbook should be wide open here for the Spy Ponders.
See if they go over the top at all. There's no deep safety for the Cougars.
So there's a little pitch, and it was intended for Adam Eluinci. And that'll bring up fourth and one. Rob, you got to figure the Spy Ponders are going for it here.
I think so. And if Eluinci can catch that ball, there was no center fielder at all for the Cougars, and we might have had a big play, but good defense by Cougars that time getting their hand on it.
Yeah, it was Michael Burke who actually was on the coverage there going both ways for the Cougars. So here it is, fourth down, folks. Big play. 5:52 left in the first quarter, scoreless. Here's Bowler going to go over to center. He's going to sneak it. Goes forward. He's pushing forward. The line pushes forward. It looks like he might have gotten it with second effort. Let's see where Stripes comes in and marks the ball. The mark's going to be all important. And they say first down for the Spy Ponders, although they have not signaled yet.
Yes,
they have. And there go those sticks for 9-10. First down.
Tremendous effort that time by Adam Bowler. He was stopped at the line of scrimmage. His legs were churning. He wasn't moving. Broke slightly to the left and through an act of will got over the first down marker.
First and 10 for the Spy Ponders. Ball of the 34. Here's Woods, gets over the right-hand side, slips a couple of tackles to about the 30, maybe to the 29, and Woods showing a little bit of spunk there.
Absolutely, good way to keep your legs moving, Elijah Woods, and right up the middle for the Ponders, and they're controlling the line of scrimmage early. And I got to point out, Scott, that Arlington Catholic is playing without a free safety here. That's going to be something that the Arlington coaches are going to notice. We'll see when they decide to take another crack over the top.
They've had a lot of success of late with that seam route down the seam in the middle of the outside. So here's Bowler in a pass run option. He's going to throw it, and it is dropped in and out of the hands that time of Leonardo Maniti. And nice little throw there by Bowler on the run.
Good read by Bowler. It was a little bit of what we would call a flood route. There are three receivers, one a little deeper, one in the middle, and one shallow. And it's up to the quarterback to find which guy is uncovered in the zone. And that time Bowler made the right read. Maniti couldn't quite come up with a football.
Yes, as you mentioned, Rob, it's a chilly 33, 34 degrees. That ball's got to be rock hard. So it's going to bring up a third and about six for the Spy Ponders. Rob, you think it's four down territory here?
I think it will be.
It will be. So see if they run it to try to set up a fourth down. They don't. A little pitch, a little catch, and a little zig and a zag and a zoom. And Adam Eluinci spins his way down to about the 12, and a nice little pitch and catch there with Bowler.
Great pitch and catch, and Eluinci does the jitterbug. Wow, fires the ball, does Adam Bowler, right on the numbers. And Eluinci does it all himself that time against three defenders.
Eluinci showing his worth, caught a touchdown pass a couple of weeks ago to spark the first Spy Ponder W of the game. And we are live over the air. Happy Thanksgiving to everyone out there in the computer land watching the game here as Adam Bowler looks on a first down to Matt Pickett. And going to bring up a second in town. Just to recap for those joining us, we're scoreless here. 4:15 left in the first quarter in the annual Turkey Day Classic. Gobble, gobble. Happy Thanksgiving to you and your family from all of us here at ACMI. Spy Ponder's driving. Adam Eluinci just had a big catch to give the Spy Ponders a first down and get themselves in business here. Second and 10. And over the right-hand side and into the end zone goes Elijah Woods. And a bing and a bang and a boom.
Wow, great time play that time by the Ponders. A little bit of a draw play. The Cougars had a blitz on. They blitzed a middle linebacker up the middle, but there were no linebackers left when the draw hit the line of scrimmage. And Elijah Woods knows just what to do with it, fights his way into the end zone. Nice play call by the Ponders. Nice execution by Elijah Woods.
So here is Swift to try the extra point for the Spy Ponders. Snaps a little high. The kick is up. And the kick is good. And with 4:07 left in the ball game, the Spy Ponders lead 7-0.
If you're tuning in, 4:07 left in the first quarter. Don't panic here, folks. We got a long way to go in this one. Great drive by the Ponders that time. We saw a little bit of everything. We saw runs up the middle. We saw the little sweep, and of course Adam Bowler with a couple of nice strikes. The big play to Eluinci, and the Ponders find themselves in the enviable position of being up 7-0 early.
It was really a spectacular play by Adam, and that really set the table there for the big Spy Ponder touchdown. So Swift will kick it off, and Cordell Parrish is back to receive for the Cougars. Again, he's way too deep. Zigging and zagging and zooming goes Burton over the 35 to maybe the 36, and that's where the Cougars will take over 12-0. And Rob, the Cougars have struggled all year long to get themselves a win. Got to be tough to get down 7-0 early.
Absolutely, Scott. They're going to be desperate to do a little something with the ball. They haven't found anything that's worked for them so far in their first two possessions of the ball game. Gone to the run, gone to the pass. The punters have really been getting great penetration.
So over the right-hand side goes Spencer Burton with a nice little gain of first down, going to bring up a second and down and eight. Little pitch and a little catch that time to Michael Stafford from Michael Burke. The Michaels making a connection there and going to bring up third and reasonable for the Cougars.
I don't believe the Cougars have had a first down yet in this ball game.
So here goes Burke over the right-hand side. Didn't even have to zigzag or zoom. Just rumbled, stumbled, bumbled, and mumbled his way over the 50 to about the Arlington Catholic 43. The Arlington High 43. That's where they'll take over first and 10, and they're going fast now. Here's Burton over the left-hand side. He's pushed back by a pack of angry Spy Ponders. And now we're seeing the Cougars get their legs under them.
Spy Ponders doing a really good job controlling the middle of the field against a really very big physical back in Spencer Burton.
Burton puts the ball on the turf but picks it up and actually gains a couple of yards and pushes forward. And, Rob, how many years this times this year have we seen the ball hit the ground and come up and be retrieved by the person who dropped it?
Yeah, we're beginning to feel that Pierce Field is like a more of a basketball court at some time. We're seeing players dribble the football.
I can tell you if I drop my plate of turkey today, it's not coming right back up into my hands.
but it will find its way into your mouth.
It
I do
sure
predict
will
that.
Into my mouth and down into my belly. I'll tell you that. So now Stripes has made a call here. Rob, do you have any idea? That's been the bane of our existence all year long with these Stripes and these calls. I don't know what the call was there. Maybe a little shenanigans after the whistle. Looks like a 15-yard penalty against the Spy Ponders, and it puts the Catholic Cougars in business first and 10 of the 26. Here's Spencer Burton over the left-hand side. He cuts back right. Nice little gain for Burton on first down, and the Cougars are really feeling it now.
So part of the Cougars' identity is that they're a power football team, and they're going to keep on working that middle. It's going to be up to the Ponders to stay stout.
Second in, we'll call it 7 for... So that time Burton is wrapped up by Cully Curran. He had some help from Jacob Marini, and the Cougars go fast here. Lost a yard. It'll be a third and a long 7 for Burke. They go empty. Coming up on 40 seconds left in the first quarter. Burke steps into a throw. It's a completed pass.
I don't think he got
that time to Seamus Holden. Going to bring up 4th and a very short 1. I think they're going to measure. Nice little pitch and catch there with Burke.
Nice toss by Burke. His first completion of the ball game, I believe, and they're going to give him the first down. So good job by the receiver knowing just where the sticks were.
They are going to give him the first down. So the ball is going to be placed at about the 16. See if they can get this playoff before the end of the first quarter.
Looked like Spencer Burton limped off before this play without Spencer on the play.
Yeah, Burton limped off, and he was replaced by Christian Santolina. And Santolina is a 5'5", 145-pound sophomore from East Boston. And after the first period, our score here at Pierce Field on Thanksgiving is Spy Ponders 7 and the Arlington Catholic Cougars nothing. But Rob, the Spy Ponders had a nice touchdown early run by Elijah Woods, but the Cougars have answered back.
Spy Ponders have to feel good about the first quarter. They move the ball two possessions, one of them a score. They move the ball through the air and on the ground. Defensively, they've also played well, have had done a good job getting penetration into the Cougar backfield. But the Cougars are finding a way to move the ball on this drive, and they would dearly love to find a way to get it in the end zone and tie up this ball game.
So, yeah, Christian Santolina is the new back in for Burton on a first and 10 for the Cougars. Burke zigs, zags, and even zooms. A nice little run for the junior. And they're going to go fast here on second and 4. 6-yard gain for Burke on first down. He's getting his instructions from Coach Clivio on the sideline. So here's Santolino over the right-hand side, slips a couple of tackles, bangs his way down to the 6-yard line, going to bring up a third and about a long one.
Nice job that time by Santolino, but we haven't seen Spencer Burton here, and that's going to be a tough break for the Cougars if he can't get back on the field.
So they're going to give Santolina a first down, so it's going to be first and goal for the Cougars at the 6. We'll see if Burke takes matters into his own hands. He's had success running the ball. This time he goes out under center on first down, and a flag comes out. We'll see what that call is.
Delay a game.
They're going to call it delay a game. Wow. Haven't seen that called a lot this year. And I think we see a little bit of snow coming down. Am I seeing that, partner?
I saw one big snowflake. For a second, I thought the official threw it out of his pocket. But not so. This is all of a sudden winter football.
Winter football has arrived at Pierce Field as here comes the snow.
We were looking at the forecast all week long, Scott, and early in the week it was forecast for snow today, and then the forecast as of yesterday was looking a little better. Looked like they got it right early. We are now seeing the snow come down with a little bit of intensity.
It sure is, and so maybe the Cougars were distracted by the snow there and got that delay of game. Who knows?
Could be. Anyway,
it's a. It's going to be a first and goal from the 11 for the Cougars. Burke's now going to take this one out of the shotgun on first down. Sprints out, little up and out route. That time it was intended for Parrish.
And that time Leonardo Maniti got right in Burke's face, and it's going to be a hard time. Jacob Marini, excuse me. Marini was right in his face, and, you know, all Burke could really do was toss the ball high out of bounds.
So second and goal for AC. Here's Burke stepping into a throw. It's intended for Seamus Holden, broken up that time by Joey Pazia, nice play by Pazia, going to bring up a third and goal from 11. And Burke goes fast. Little pitch, little catch. That time by Colin, and he's smacked down at about the 10, and Rob going to bring up a fourth and goal from the 10, and I don't think they have any chance but to go for it here.
We'll see if they have a kicker who can make a 30-yard field goal. Looks like no is the answer, and they're going to go for it. So Burke fired the ball into a tight window on second down, couldn't come up with it, and tried a short pass on third down. Now they're going to have to get into the end zone.
Looking for Holden on an out cut, and it was almost picked off that time by Elyounce, and the Spy Ponders hold a big goal line stand, and Rob, it's kind of reminiscent of last week.
Yeah, last week the Spy Ponders won 14-8 against Boston Latin and had a couple of big goal line stands. It was a very exciting game for the Ponders and a big game for Adam Bowler. He had a touchdown pass and a touchdown running, threw for 220 yards, ran for 70 yards. Great game by Bowler and nice win by the Ponders. And the two goal line stands have to give the defense a lot of confidence coming into this week. We'll have to go. Ponders will have to go 90 yards this time, on a very cold field.
So here's Bowler, going left. It's complete down the sideline. Goes Cully Curran, cuts back at the 20, zigs and zags, and he can even zoom, and he walks in backwards, doing a moonwalk. Goes Cully Curran, and a bing, and a bang, and a boom. Gobble, gobble.
Wow, let's watch this replay. Oh, the defender goes for the interception, and it doesn't quite get there. Let's see Cully Curran go to the middle of the field, cut back, just like a Superman movie with the bad guys falling all over themselves, and couldn't quite get there, and Cully Curran walks backward in the end zone. 90-yard play for the Ponders, and they go up 13-0.
Wow, I don't think I've ever seen that on a high school football field. Put some mustard on that hot dog, Cully Curran. Here is Sam Swift to kick the extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is good. And with 8:23 left in the first half, your Spy Ponders take a 14-0 lead. And Rob, I gotta be 100% honest with you. Was that a little bit much there? hot dogging it into the end zone. I mean, he literally came to a walk and took the last three steps backwards into the end zone.
I got to say, it was a little bit exciting. So first, Michael Stanford goes for the pick and doesn't quite get there. So Cully Curran catches a bowler, just threw a strike, and Curran catches it. He's running free, and then from behind comes Michael Stanford. Looked like he was going to get caught, and then Cully Curran makes a series of moves, first to the center of the field, then cutting back to the outside. So I think his backwards into the end zone was as much relief as anything that he didn't get caught from behind.
That's a live football. That's absolutely a live football, and wisely Cordell Parrish steps on the ball, and he's lucky because Matt Pickett was making a beeline for it, wanted to scoop it up for the Spy Ponders. And right now, Rob, all the momentum is with the boys from Pierce Field.
Important moment in the game for the Cougars. They are they need to at least get a first down here and kind of stem the bleeding. The Ponders are as you say, they have the momentum and they're really kind of feeling it. Nice timeout that time. I'm sure this is by Serge Clivio trying to kind of cut the momentum a little bit for them.
And Rob, you mentioned Serge Clivio. We were talking last night about Serge and the type of coach he is and how the respect that we have for him. Tell the folks at home a little bit about your thoughts about Serge Clivio.
Well, I think my comment last night was that I would be very kind of proud and happy if my son played football for Serge Clivio. He's the kind of coach who's a real leader and kind of a shaper of young men out there through his work as a football coach.
So first and 10 for Burke. And there's Spencer Burton back in the game, but he's met rudely by a pair of spy ponders led by Cully Curran, who's been all over the field making a bid for player of the game already. Second and 11, and they'll go fast again. Here's Burke looking to run it or pass it. He's going to throw it. It's intended for Parrish, and that's going to bring up third and long. And, Rob, the danger going fast always is you get a three and out, now your defense is railed.
That's a really good point, Scott. And, right back out on the field right after the quick strike by the Ponders. It's not what they want to see.
So Burke's slow, even though they don't huddle, they're still slowing it up a little bit here on a third and 11. Tough down and distance for anybody. Here's Burke, little pitch, a little catch. He's pushed out of bounds, goes Jack Driscoll, but that's not going to be enough, and the Cougars are going to have to punt the ball away.
Cougars really haven't found anything that's consistently working for them in this ball game. They, we're pounding the ball into the middle early with Spencer Burton and with not a lot of success, and Burke hasn't been able to find receivers yet, and they have an unfortunate for them three and out. They're going to give the ball back to the Ponders with good field position.
So Burton kicks the ball, takes a nice Cougar bounce, going to settle down at about the 39. Back to receiver Arlington was Elijah Woods, and he was wise not to touch that. And so, Rob, so now we got 14-0 for the Spy Ponders, leading with 7 minutes left in the first half. Playbook is certainly wide open for them.
Well, Coach Rendon shown that he's not afraid to take to the air, and not with little dinks and dunks, but to throw the ball downfield. And I would expect that they're going to continue to do that until Arlington Catholic shows that they can stop it.
So first and 10 for the Spy Ponders. Here's Bowler on a keeper. He ran for 75 yards last week. This time he's wrapped up by Nico Fernandez-Cote. And Fernandez-Cote brings him down with a bad intent.
And Bowler comes up limping a little bit. Kind of limping over to the sidelines. Let's see if Keenan Varney comes
and
in.
Yes, yeah. Here comes Keenan Varney. And Varney, a junior, has had quite a bit of experience for the Spy Ponders right here. But you don't like to see Bowler, who had a lot of success with a rushing TD and passing TD last week, limp to the sideline. So here's Varney on his first play on a Thanksgiving Day. And he hands it off to Woods over the left-hand side. He's able to push his way over the 45 to about 43 to about the 44, and that's going to bring up a third and 5, and Varney will stay in the game.
Yeah, lucky for the Ponders that they got some yardage on that play, because Keenan Varney came in unexpectedly, didn't have a chance to warm up at all, so Ponders most likely are going to have to stay on the ground here.
And it is ice cold today, folks. Can't be a tick above 34, 35 degrees, if that. Here's that jet sweep, and the ball hits the turf, and if pass is prologue, it will be Spy Ponder ball. And it is Spy Ponder ball as, again, there goes a fumble that pops right back up into the offender's hands, and the Spy Ponders keep the ball.
Fortuitous play by the offender.
Yes.
No doubt. Keenan Varney, dropped the ball. It was unclear whether
egregious.
That was going to go to the egregious. I don't even know what that means. So was the ball going to the wide receiver for the sweep or the back? We'll never know.
We will never know. It would be one of the great secrets. And here's a bad punt that the Spy Ponders wisely field. Kind of went off the side of Sam Swift's foot. And so the Cougars will get good field position. That's really just what they needed right there.
Yeah, good break for the Cougars. Looked like that was almost a designed play. If that ball had been thrown and not kicked, that would have been a perfect play by the Ponders. Unfortunately, it doesn't work that way.
No, it doesn't work that way. No, he would have streaked down the sideline for a touchdown. Right. Could have moonwalked in from there. First and 10 for the Cougars. Here's Burke. Now he's going to tuck it and run. He falls over the 45 to about the 44. I'll tell you, Rob, this Burke's got a little bit of spunk in him.
Yeah, he does, and so does the Ponder secondary. I tell you, Scott, great coverage that time by the Ponders. And I think there's been really no part of this football team that's improved this year more than the secondary of the Ponders.
So second and 7, the Spy Ponders show blitz but back off. The run pass option there. The completion is to Cordell Parrish, and he's hit hard by Cully Curran.
I think that was Nicholas Samuelson Hawley that time.
Nicholas Samuelson Hawley in on the play.
He's got a lot of kind of white handkerchiefs hanging out of his helmet, out of his pants. Very styling young man is Samuelson Hawley.
Sure is. Third and 5. Spy Ponders jump off sides on a hard count, but they don't snap it, so they don't throw the flag. Spencer Burton. And there's the little pitch and a little catch that time to Cordell Parrish. Going to bring up a 4th and 1. And, Rob, you have to think that this is 4-down territory for the Cougars.
Well, they're going to go for it. 3 minutes left in the half. So if they don't get the 4th down, there's going to be enough time left for the Ponders to respond and still get in the end zone. So this is actually an important play for the Cougars. Could be a 14-point switch here, depending on how it goes.
Here's Burke. He's going to keep it on 4th down. He gets the 1st down and more. He falls to about the 32. That time he was wrapped up by Ayunsi.
Nice play that time by the Cougars. The Ponders blitzed to the outside, and the Cougars had the right play call on, reminiscent of the Ponders' first touchdown of the game. Wow, great play that time by number 11, Leonardo Menini, in the backfield, almost got to the quarterback before the football did. Pins him back 15 yards. Big play by the Ponders.
Huge play by Menini. Brings up a 2nd in California as we come up on 2 minutes left in the half. So here's a little completion to Cordell Parrish, and Parrish will go down to about the 36. And Rob, I think you're going to head down to the field. We're going to try and see if we can get an interview with the coach, with Coach Gendron at halftime, see if we can get that to happen. Meanwhile, we got a 3rd and 15 here for the Cougars. Empty backfield for Burke.
Here we go.
Flag on the play. We'll see what that is. So it looks like he's going to be on the Cougars. It's a holding. So here's, look at Stripes methodically walking that off. Look at that Stripes there. Wow. Excellent mechanics there by Stripes marking off that hold. They've done an excellent job today. Going to bring up three. If that was California, this is Hawaii here for the Cougars, who face a very difficult third down here. Twins the top of your screen and the bottom for Burke. Low snap. Burke steps in with throw. It's complete. Nice little pitch and catch there with Cordell Parrish. And so that's going to, clock rolls. We're coming up on 35 seconds left. So here's Burke on a run pass option. He gets slammed out of bounds by Pazia, and John Bowen made a sandwich with Burke, and the clock stops with Sitkins left in the first half, and that's where the Spy Ponders will take over. First and 10, leading 14 to nothing. So here's Varney. And now here's Elijah Woods to the 50. To the 40, he's finally shoved out of bounds by Jack Thorpe, but not before a big gain, and the clock stops with 5 seconds left in the first half. As we look there, a big hole. I could have run through there, and Woods took care of the rest, showing his speed. 5 seconds left. 5 seconds left in the first half. Barney gets his instructions from Coach Gendron, Mr. Positivity. Tell him you can do it.
Let's go!
So a little bit of confusion here with Stripes. They get together to see if they're on the same page here. They are. Spy Ponders will huddle back up. Now they won't. Kind of a little bit of a sugar huddle there. And so here's Varney with 5 seconds left. Little pitch, and it's a little catch. And there's that man, Cully Curran. He's zigging and zagging and even zooming. And he's finally brought down at the 12-yard line. And that's where your first half will end, with the Spy Ponders from Arlington leading 14 to nothing. As there you see the junior, Cully Curran, zigging and zagging and even zooming.
Well, it's been a very difficult season as far as wins and losses go, but the team has had a great attitude. They're continuing to work hard, you know, right through the season, even though we've haven't been able to win a game yet. But the team is really putting a lot of effort into the season. And as I said, I have not had any, downturn in their effort or any of that. They're working hard right through the season. And so I'm very pleased with their effort. It's been hard because Christian Rosati was our quarterback, and he was a 3-year starter for us. So as far as that goes, we're doing a whole new system, implementing with a whole new quarterback, and really a very, very young team. We're starting probably six or seven sophomores, you know, six or seven juniors, and just a few seniors playing. And very few seniors came back with experience. So we knew that it was going to be a difficult undertaking. But, you know, they worked hard in the offseason. It's been, it's been a tough season, but they're continuing to work hard. Spencer Burton and Nico Fernandez-Cody have really kept a very strong attitude. And all the seniors have pitched in and kept a positive attitude. Kieran Mullen has probably been the most improved through the season. He's suffered through a couple of injuries, but he certainly has given us a great deal more than we may have expected at the beginning. And, you know, he's an extremely hard worker. And high school football is a great opportunity to teach young men discipline, respect, hard work, and the belief in, a team and what you can accomplish if you work together. And so I think those things are part of my educational philosophy anyway, as a theology teacher, the belief in, you know, family and faith and teamwork and discipline. Those are all hallmarks that I want the team to exhibit also. Last year, we lost a very, very close game on Thanksgiving. It went down really to the last play of the game. And we had a chance to score and didn't on the last play. And so, you know, again, winning that, getting back in the column, winning that game helps really to make the season. It wipes out almost everything you've done before. To the young people, it's something. Thanksgiving game is something you remember for the rest of your life. You know, the excitement, the passion, you know, the people who show up for the game. And I think the same holds true for this.
And we're back at halftime with the Spy Ponders lead 14-0. And we are lucky to be joined by an Arlington High School football legend, John Solomon. Welcome back, John. How does it feel to be back at Arlington High?
It's always great to come home and visit and see the guys. Got to see Coach Hanley this morning, brought back good memories about practicing here in November. What it was like playing some of them, those great Thanksgiving Day games.
So looking back, John, you played on the last team that went to a championship game. Tell us a little bit about what year that was and the experience you had.
It was 1995. You know, I was a sophomore then, was lucky enough to make the varsity team that year. We had some great battles with, I remember, with Peabody in this field. We played, for some reason, we ended up playing a Sunday afternoon against Waltham. And then Thanksgiving against Somerville here, which was absolute, you know, madness towards the end when we clinched it in the celebration on the field. And, you know, playing with the seniors, Dan Picone, Matt Lee, Dean Rafferty, you know, Sean Walsh, Randy St. Elmy, Jonathan Cooper, you know, the list just goes on and on. What a great group of guys to follow in that tradition from the team. I think it was 92 or 93, a couple years before that had made it to the Super Bowl. So it was exciting times here on that Thanksgiving back in 1995.
Certainly was exciting times. And so, John, as you look out in the field today and you see seniors out there for the last time, you certainly can relate to what they're going through.
Yeah, you know, the emotions of the last time playing on this field, last time playing with a lot of your friends, you know, being part of the METCO program. You know, I've known the kids that I played with them for 4 years, but you know, we had guys on our teams that had been playing with each other since Pop Warner, since it started in third grade. You know, being the last time to play with all your friends, it is an emotional time. And, you know, hopefully for these seniors, they'll be able to go out with a win and, you know, be able to carry that memory when they come back next year for Thanksgiving and catching up with all their friends and families and stuff like that and recalling that.
And that's what Thanksgiving Day is, all about family. And I know you got a wonderful family up there in Maine. What are you up to these days? You coaching?
I'm coaching up there in Maine. I live in a town, Holton. I joke, but it's literally right across the street from Canada right now. We're a third-year varsity program that's growing. Great community, great school system for my kids. They're both enjoying it up there, and we're just having a good time.
You sure are. And it's just, we're so happy to have you here on Thanksgiving Day. A true legend, John Solomon. Thanks a lot and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, guys.
All
go
right.
Bonders.
There you go. And we'll be back right after this. And we're back. It's our now become a Turkey Day tradition to have the Arlington High School boys head basketball coach and legend John Bowler with us. John, happy Thanksgiving to you.
Thanks, you too, Scott.
And so, John, we talked a little bit before about some of the players in the past. Now we look forward as Thanksgiving comes. Practice starts Monday. Tell us a little bit about this year's team and what you have coming up this year.
Yeah, you know, we're very excited about this year's team. You know, coming off winning 19 games last year, you know, we have three starters back, Colin McNamara, James Gascoigne, and Dom Black. We're very excited. A lot of players from the JV team have made big improvement over the summer. So we're going to be young. But I think we're going to be, exciting team to watch. Great style of play to get up and down, and just try to defend everywhere.
Now, we talk a lot on Thanksgiving about community. I want to bring it specifically with your team, your coaching staff, specifically Jack Woods, and the role that he and you both play in the community.
Yeah, Jack's been, with me the whole time I've been at Arlington High, so it's kind of like our team, our program that we've built. He's like having another head coach out there. It's great. I work full time at the boys club. He's at Fidelity House, so we see, all of the kids, growing up. We coach a lot of the kids growing up, so it's great to see them, as young players develop into leaders on our team.
Absolutely. Now, so. So some of your young players, you said you have a sophomore this year? That's
Yeah, James Gascoigne. He started every game with a freshman. He's very skilled. He's about 6'2", 6'3". He's really improved from, the off season this year, too. He probably averaged 11 points a game as a freshman. We can really expect big things from him, this year and in the future.
That's awesome. So it looks like the future is very bright for the Spy Ponders basketball program. Football team future looks bright maybe today. We'll see. But at any rate, happy Thanksgiving to you and your family, John.
Thank you. You too, Scott.
Awesome. Thanks a lot. And we'll be right back right after this. Oh. And we're back. We are lucky to be joined again this year with Arlington High Athletic Director Melissa Dugalecki. Melissa, happy Thanksgiving
to you.
Happy
Thanksgiving.
Thank you. And so, Melissa, let's take a look back at the fall sports. And how did things go with the Spy Ponders in the fall?
Yeah, it was a great fall. A lot of energy. Teams performed really well. Our girls soccer team made it all the way to the state championship game.
Wow.
Which was incredible. And they played into overtime of that game. So that's how well matched to be the top team in the state, they were.
Wow.
Yeah, it was incredible. Boys cross country had an outstanding performance at states. It was the first time they qualified as a team in a few years. And swimming, they had their best performance in a long time. It's sectionals, and they sent five swimmers to the state competition as well.
That's phenomenal.
Yeah.
That's awesome. So it looks like you had a very successful fall slate. We're hoping maybe we get another W here
exactly.
For the football team. Looking nice for that.
Yes.
But now we look ahead, and what Thanksgiving does besides fill our bellies and have love in our family, it turns us over to a new sport, and that's the winter sports. Yeah. What do we have for winter?
Well, winter kicks off on Monday, so we quickly catch our breath, and then we're ready to go. And we have boys and girls basketball, hockey, boys and girls hockey, gymnastics, wrestling, and both boys and girls indoor track.
And you mentioned, I just want to get this out there again, because I was listening to a broadcast from earlier in the year when we were talking, the participation level. What was the number of students you had participate
we
in
had
athletics
this
year?
We had about 30% higher in registrations. So with rosters, our numbers are up quite a bit. We had over 400 fall athletes, and right now with winter, we're looking to be in the mid-300s.
I just think that is really fantastic, and I wanted to really emphasize that on a day of community, a day
yeah,
where
we're
thinking like that people are getting involved. It really is a credit to you, to the program, but most importantly, to the community, to the leaders and the athletes in the programs that you set forward, because I just think that things are going great here at Arlington, and I couldn't be more happy.
Oh, great. Yeah, we have wonderful coaches, wonderful athletes. So
you sure
it's good
do.
Stuff.
So thanks for stopping by, and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Awesome. And we'll be back right after this. And we're back for the second half as the Spy Ponders lead 14-0. And before we start talking about what we might think happened in the second half, partner, why don't you recap the scoring for us?
Two scores in the ball game, both for the Arlington Spy Ponders. Elijah Woods opened the scoring with a 12-yard run on a little draw play with 4:07 left in the first quarter. Then we got the big 90-yard pass play from Bowler to Cully Curran. Exciting chase all the way down here to the western sideline. Curran walking into the end zone with 8:07 left in the half to bring the score to 14-0, which is where we stand right now.
It is where we stand. And, Rob, I'd have to say the touchdown for Cully Curran was probably the highlight of the season so far.
Yeah, one of the more exciting plays we've seen. And you know, what's been most impressive to me in this first half is Adam Bowler, how much control he's had over the football on a very cold day. We've got 34 degrees. Football is hard and cold, and yet Bowler has been tossing it, firing it into tight windows. Very impressive performance by him.
Very impressive performance by him. There were a few injuries in the first half. John Nascimento Jr., a senior, John Nascimento Jr.
Yes.
Went down with an injury, and also Adam Bowler went down. So it'll be interesting to see as we see Bowler warming up here in front of us. We can get a shot of that. But so it'll be interesting to see who starts for quarterback in the second half. But Rob, now let's look over the. Over the other side at Arlington Catholic, they're down 14-0. They kind of found their way a little bit, but they haven't really been able to punch the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they had that one good drive, didn't they, where they moved the ball really, thanks to the good work by quarterback Michael Burke running the ball a little bit. But for the most part, the Cougars haven't yet found anything that's going to work for them. The Ponders defensive line has been really, almost dominant. They've had great penetration and put a lot of pressure on the Cougar offense. So the Cougars are going to have to look for a way to kind of break the pressure. How do they do it? Well, we'll see. Burke has been running the ball well. Maybe they mix in some little screen plays, try to loosen the defense up by going over the top. But it's a tall order today for the Cougars.
It is a tall order, but, Rob, if there's anything we know about a Serge Clivio team, they're going to be innovative.
They're going to be innovative, and they are a well-coached team. They're able to adjust at halftime. So there will be some adjustments. We'll just have to keep our eyes on what they're going to be. And for the Spy Ponders, it looks like Bowler's going to go. He's warming up in front of us. He is, and you can see he is not favoring his left ankle, which is, I believe, what got them down in the first half.
So Curran and...
And Woods.
And Woods we back to receive for the Spy Ponders. And Seamus Holden will do the kicking. Actually, that will not be Seamus Holden. He'll be doing the barking of signals. The kicking actually will be done by Joseph Greerney. And here, oh, a big punishing hit there by the kicker Greerney, who got down on the play and just absolutely pasted.
Was that Cully Curran?
Cully Curran.
So there's some karma there, Mr. Curran. You've got to get as good as you give.
Woo!
Curran backed into the end zone on his touchdown play and got a little payback there from an angry, hungry Cougar.
Oh, that was the end of the year. So here's Woods, who finished the first half with a nice run, continues his success over the left-hand side, and Elijah Woods kind of showing us what he's got.
Elijah Woods has some spunk. He's not the biggest player on the field, but he has one of the biggest hearts. And at that time, with a stiff arm there as he ran around the left hand side, he came to play.
He sure did come to play. So Varney,
looks like we got Varney here.
So here's Varney in as Bowler warms up on the sideline. Looks like he's got his leg tape. Is that tape on his leg, Rob?
Yeah, his right. Looks like his right leg, high above the ankle.
High snap. Gets it off to Woods, who can't go anywhere, on a loss of about 3 or 4. That's going to bring up 3rd and 7. And this is not where Mr. Varney wants to be on a 35-degree turkey day.
No. That high snap is a little bit costly there, threw off the rhythm of the play, and Elijah Woods that time found himself with the with the football, and the hole had already closed.
So 3rd and 7, clock rolls with coming up on 10:05 left in the third. Varney's going to go deep. It's a good ball, and it's caught. There it is. Adam Elyounce into the end zone. He puts a little mustard on that hot dog, and a bing, and a bang, and a boom. Gobble, gobble.
Wow, big play that time. Keenan Varney with a 62-yard play to Elyounce. And, you could see it there. Varney made a nice play, but the defender kind of fell down. And Elyounce came up with it and then just kind of walked into the end zone from the 35-yard line. Ponders strike. Get on the board early in the second half. Nice to see Keenan Varney have some success and get a big touchdown throw.
Varney with a perfect spiral that was right where it needed to be, where Elyounce could grab it, and the Spy Ponders with this kick, which is up, and the kick is good, and with 9:55 left in the third period, the Spy Ponders take a commanding 21-0 lead. And Rob, you talked early that you thought that the defense for the Cougars was giving the Spy Ponders the possibility some deep action.
Yeah, the Cougars have been playing up towards the line of scrimmage and really kind of selling out. On a cold day, that makes some sense, thinking that the Ponders might be going with a short passing game in the run, but the Ponders have not hesitated to go with the matchups and take what the defense has given them and go over the top. And so far, they've had two big touchdown plays of over 60 yards.
So yeah, Sam's.
I was going to say, Scott, it's nice to see a lot of Ponders contributing here. We've got Woods, Curran, and Elyounce all getting in the end zone. We'll work on that later.
we promise.
Sorry, Adam.
El Yunsi. I've got it.
Whatever happened to Smith and Jones? we got to recruit some Smiths and some Joneses into this program.
Some Joes and Bobs.
Yeah. I don't know. We try our best, folks.
It was, a spectacular play by El Yunsi. And so the Cougars would take over first and 10 from the 30. And over the right-hand side goes Burton, and he's wrapped up by Pazia. Flag comes in late. We'll see what that is.
We had a little extracurriculars that time. Looks like Leonardo Maniti was getting into it with number 50 for the Cougars, who would be Justin Smith, and they're gonna tag Maniti with that one.
Yeah, they are. And when a game gets to 21-0 and there's a scuffle, the team that's winning 21-0 usually pays the price.
Yeah, good point, and probably rightfully so.
Absolutely rightfully so. We've talked here for years. We like good hard play, but we don't like dirty play. And when it gets dirty, the officials need to step in. And they did there. So first and 10. A little pitch. Not really sure who that was intended for. Maybe a little miscommunication there for Michael Burke. And Rob, is it possible that it's getting a little colder out here?
I think it's possible that it's getting colder. I will alert the fans that I broke out the hand warmers for the first time ever for me in the booth here at Pierce Field.
Wow.
We had snow in the first
half. Mark this day.
Yes.
So second and 10, there's a little pitch and a catch. Burke to Cordell Parrish. And, Rob, this Cordell Parrish has got a little bit of spunk in him.
I think so. They've got some – Arlington Catholic has some big receivers, some height. Cordell Parrish is a big receiver, and number 8, Seamus Holden is a big receiver, some targets.
You know, the size all around. The receivers are big. The line is big. It's a big team, big young team. 3rd and 3. Low snaps on the ground, and Burke has to just fall on it as Joey Pazia stares over him. And
– wow.
You know, as we see Pazia coming up to make a big play there, or poised to make a big play, my man Michael Doherty, who I think is, for my money, has been the Spy Ponder's MVP this season. And when you look to the future and who's going to fill his shoes, I think Pazia is a real good contender.
Pazia is a contender, but I got to tell you, he's going to have to work for it in the offseason. There's an opportunity, there's a job open, but the player that works the hardest is going to win the job.
So here's Burke. He throws the ball just to get it away out of bounds. And Rob, it's funny you bring that up, because we started the year in the broadcast using the word meritocracy.
Yeah, right.
And if you saw this week, the quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys, Tony Romo, came out with a very elegant speech.
Yep.
And talked about football being a meritocracy, just what you said.
Yeah.
And that's what it has been here for the Spy Ponders, and it's what's going to be happening moving forward.
Absolutely. And it's absolutely as it should be with a young football team. Guys got to learn how to earn it.
2nd and 10. There's a little pitch and a little catch. It's Burke there to Kieran Mullen, a 5'9", 145-pounder from Billerica, Mass. And the sticks will move for the Spy Ponder, for the Arlington Cougars.
A couple of first downs here for the Cougars. They're finding a way to move the ball. Burke throwing to his left.
Here's Burke throwing to his right. This time it is caught, by Seamus Holden. And Holden there did a nice job bringing the ball using his body.
Yeah, he did. He was immediately met by three spy punters. So, you know, Holden did a good job hanging on to it, and the punters did a good job, you know, making contact right when the ball arrived.
Second and four. And here goes Burton over the right-hand side. He's tripped up that time by Michael Mazzy. And Mazzy's had a nice year for the Spy Ponders.
You know, at the high school football level, you want to control the middle of the football field and make the offense work to the outside and use speed. Quarterbacks don't always have the arm to get the ball deep to the outside. And one thing the punters have done is control the middle of the football field increasingly as the season's worn on.
Third and four. Burke running for his life. He slips a couple tackles, slips three, but can't slip a fourth. And finally in comes Cully Kern with a little bit of help, and it'll bring down fourth down. And I'll tell you, this Michael Burke is slippery.
He's doing it with his feet. Let's see. That's one tackle, two tackles. Doesn't go down. Finally took three punters to get him down.
Yeah, Manini and Curry made a Burke sandwich there. Just like we'll be making turkey sandwiches tomorrow. So here's a fourth down, and I think that's going to be a false start by the Cougars, and that's not what you need on a fourth and five, down 21-0 with 5:59 left in the third.
It's like that time everybody heard the snap count in the huddle, but the guy with the ball, the center. Always too bad when that happens. And fourth and five is a much more favorable position to be in than fourth and 10, especially since Burke has been converting on this drive with little 6 and 7 yard passes.
There's Burke. That's the same thing. That's the exact same thing.
I'll point out, Scott, one thing I like to see is that when Burke throws to his left, he drops straight back and has his whole body open to the left-hand side, and that's something I'd like to see Adam Bowler work on over the offseason. Bowler will take a normal drop and have to look hard over his left shoulder to see the left-hand side of the field. And I think the way that Burke does it here is a good role model.
He's thrown very well to his left all game. So fourth and 15 now, they will go for it. They're going deep. He's got a man down there. It is incomplete, broken up by Cully Curran, intended for Cordell Parrish, and Parrish was open.
Wow, he was two steps behind Cully Curran that time. If the throw was a little bit further, they might have gotten six. That time the ball hit Curran. Curran was scrambling to keep up with the play, and the ball kind of hit him on the helmet.
Hit him on the helmet. It was a pretty nice pass, a well-executed play. First time we've really seen him go over the top there. And unfortunately, though, for the Cougars, they're going to turn the ball over on downs, and the Spy Ponders will take the football at the 47-yard line, leading 21-0 with 5:15 left in the third. And Keenan Varney in at quarterback. Another high snap. Over the right-hand side goes Elijah Woods, who's had a tremendous turkey day. And, Rob, I got to tell you, I'm impressed with how Varney's come in today in tough conditions, freezing cold conditions, and executed the game plan.
He's done a great job. He's a junior, and one of the things as a backup quarterback, you have to always be ready. That's easier said than done, to stay tuned into a football game when you're the backup, and Keenan Varney did it, and give credit to him for that.
So second and eight for the Spy Ponders, another high snap. Here's Varney running it over the right-hand side, and the flag comes in the area where you're going to see some holding. And, Rob, we've Yeah, complained a little bit about these holding calls, but if we're going to be honest, we caught ourselves in a replay of a broadcast giving the officials the business.
Let's not be honest.
And we saw that maybe we made a little bit of a mistake. So the only reason I bring that up is because me especially, I've been extra hard on stripes this year. And we were caught giving them a little bit of the business, and maybe we were wrong on that one. But and everyone's wrong once in their life.
Well, this is the fine.
That was our turn.
Fine tradition of being a sports fan. You've got to complain about the calls.
Of course you do. Of course you do. Especially from Boston with the legendary Johnny Most. A little play action. Varney's got time. He's going to throw. It's a little duck up there. And it was intended for El Yunsi. And he could. It was a jump ball. Anyone could have had it on that one.
Yeah, the math was not in the punter's favor there. That time, though, there were three defenders and two punters. It was really anybody's ball. Fell harmlessly to the ground, and we go forward with third and long.
We sure do. And with 35-degree temperatures and maybe plummeting in a 21-0 ball game, winning plays. Even on Thanksgiving.
Yeah. Oh, we've ticked up to a balmy 37, according to the trusty iPhone.
Well, I can tell you it's not 37 degrees out. There is just there's no way it is 37 degrees out.
Oh, we had snow earlier in the ballgame, yeah. So doesn't snow at 37.
No, it is not 37 degrees out. So that'll bring up fourth down for the Spy Ponders. They're going to punt it. Swift will come in to punt, and Parrish will be back to receive for the Cougars. And
so Adam Bowler's still warming up there on the sidelines. Looks like he still thinks he has a hope of getting back into this ballgame. Limping a little bit, but he's able to kind of plant that right foot in warm-ups anyway.
I don't think we will be seeing any more Mr. Bowler in this football game.
You don't think so?
I do not. I think he's done for the day. I think he's over there. That is a little bit of wishful thinking on his part, taking these tosses. But I could be wrong. We'll see.
Indiscretion of youth, perhaps?
Maybe a little bit so. As this Bowler, a super sophomore, has a couple of good years ahead of him. And we'll talk a little bit about Bowler and the super sophomores after this play. So it looks like they're going to go after the kick here. And here's the whistle on the play, a flag, and they're going to call a little bit of false start for the Spy Ponders, and they'll go back even more. So that'll be fourth and 20. And so a well-played, fun game is kind of screeched to a halt. Professor, what do we got going on here?
We've got Stripes asserting himself.
They sure are.
About five flags in the last series.
That football's got to be impossible to kick. It goes out of bounds at about the 48. Sam Swift is going to have to, well, he's not going to ice his leg. He's going to warm it up after this. But
I was down there at halftime. It's actually a pretty hard-hitting football game. These rivalry games, as we always discuss, are really for bragging rights. We have eight players on the Arlington Catholic Cougars who hail from the city of Arlington, and they grew up with the Spy Ponders and are kind of always have a little extra pep in their step, a little extra pop in their hits, and that's what's going on the football field today.
Well, we saw the hit of the year there on Cully Curran by the kicker, Joseph Grierney. So here's Burke going to his left. That's where he's had a lot of success. That's a little pitch and catch with Cordell Parrish. And I'll tell you this, Burton there, this is a junior. He's got another year ahead of him. He's got a nice little arm.
Yeah, he does. They're saying that ball was dropped. The punter said that, and the refs agreed. So that's kind of too bad. You know, Serge Clivio's found a matchup that he likes, that little spot on the left about 7-8 yards downfield has been open a few times. And we go for it again.
And he's going to go for it again, and that's, you know, we were talking last night in our pre-production that that when Clivio finds something, a matchup that he likes, he'll hammer it.
And he's found it, and they've done it. They haven't been able to kind of sustain a drive all the way through into the end zone.
So third and 10, 2:12 left in the third for Burke. He's got time. Steps into his throw. And, you know, that right there, I think, is the cold showing there. That's kind of a catchable ball, but it's thrown hard. And, you know, I mean, 3 months ago, we were playing in 75-degree weather.
Yeah.
And now it's 33 degrees. There's a big difference.
That's caught in 75
that's
degrees.
That's easily caught in 70-degree weather. I'm not trying to make excuses for the kid, but, I mean, it's just a tough ball to catch.
Yeah. I think that's right. And he kind of sat down in the zone there, and the quarterback did a nice job kind of finding him in the zone. The punters were in a two-deep safety look, and that seam is going to be open.
So Burton will kick, and Woods will receive. It's a catchable ball. He's gone left well all season long, and he continues to do it as he trips over the 40 to about the 43. Well, they're going to actually call him out at the 36. And I'll tell you, Elijah Woods goes well left.
Yeah, let's see what happens here. Kind of a low kick. Woods does a nice job fielding the ball and just kind of sprints down the sideline. You know, Woods had some speed. I noticed that at the just before halftime. I was down on the field also. He's a fast player.
So first and 10 for the Spy Ponders at the 36, 1:56 left in a crawling third quarter.
Woods again.
Woods going right. He's got tons of room. Bounces to the outside, then zigzags and zooms. The 49 goes Elijah Woods, the junior, and that's good for Arlington. First down.
Woods showing tremendous vision on that play. He was, he had a full head of steam, and he still saw a way to kind of stop and let the defense overrun him. Very versatile back. Elijah Woods, you get him into space and good things happen. Sometimes gets bottled up by the big guys inside, but once he gets into the second level, he knows how to make people miss.
Knows how to make people miss, knows what he's doing. First and 10, and flag comes out now. That's going to be another delay game, the second one, I believe, on the Spy Ponders, if I'm seeing the mechanics right. Let's see if we can get Stripes marching this off. Can we get a close-up of Stripes there, guys? Get a close-up of Stripes. There you go. Look, methodical Stripes. Marching off 5 yards. Wow, Stripes there.
Decisive move by
Very
Stripes.
Decisive.
As decisive a play as we've seen on any of the three teams who are out there today.
Absolutely. There's always three teams in the field. So first and 15. After the Spy Ponders got caught breaking the rules. Here's Varney. Off to Woods over the right-hand side. That time he's met by some angry Cougars. And here's a little bit of extracurricular stuff after the whistle with Shane Fitzgerald getting into it with Elijah Woods. Elijah Woods is kind of taken away from the action to settle himself down. And, Rob, tempers are flaring here.
Tempers are flaring in the rivalry. Looks like march that off against the Ponders. Whatever happened down there, it looks like maybe they're going to – Woods is going to get the brunt of it, which is unusual because he's the guy who's laying on his back. Whatever happened there, it's hard to think that he really initiated.
It's hard to think he initiated it, and they're going to call a personal foul against the Spy Ponders. Now, my question to you, Rob, has Elijah Woods been ejected from this football game? They didn't signal anything, but he came off the field in an aggressive manner as if, like,
the ref just called it. Woods was.
So Woods has been ejected from this football game, and that'll be 15 yards against the Spy Ponders. I didn't see anything, but, you know, we haven't seen a player ejected all year, and I'm gonna have to side with the Stripes here and say obviously something happened that was unsportsmanlike.
It had to have been very unsportsmanlike, and again, Woods, the ball carrier, was on the ground when it happened. He must have really taken exception to something.
Here's Varney, a nice ball by Varney, and it is caught. And that is Eljunsi over the 40 to the 39, and a beautiful pass.
Wow, let's look at this. Second and 30, and Varney throws a nice spiral, just lays it up there. And Eljunsi comes down with it. Really great execution by the spy punters on second and 30.
Second and 30, and they convert. Easy as pie, like the cherry pie I'm going to be eating later today. Over the left-hand side this time, banging and banging and booming, stumbling, bumbling, and mumbling goes my man Joey Pazia, the super sophomore.
Super sophomore, no problem, says Joey Pazia. John Nascimento Jr. is down with an ankle. Elijah Woods is out of the ball game. Give the ball to me. I'm not going down, coach. I'm staying on my feet.
No, he's not. And Pazia shows the toughness that makes him who he is. And Rob, as we come to the end of the third quarter with the Spy Ponders leading 21-0, why don't you give us a little recap, tell us how we got there.
Three big plays by the Ponders. Woods opened the scoring with a 12-yard run on a little draw play, 4:07 left in the first quarter. Then we had the big 90-yard pass from Bowler to Curran with 8:07 left to go in the half. And then Keenan Varney makes a big play, a 62-yard pass to Adam Eljunsi with 9:55 in the third. That brings us to 21-0. And I tell you, Scott, the Ponders have been dominant so far in this football game. 21-0 is beginning to reflect that dominance, but they deserve to get in the end zone one more time. Let's see if the Cougars can stop them.
First and 10. Here's Pazzi over the left-hand side. He's got room. He falls forward and a nice gain. Wrapped up that time by Michael Stanford, but not before Pazia gains 9 yards. And Pazia making a statement that he wants to be part of the meritocracy for next year.
Absolutely. There's sometimes you're the hammer, sometimes you're the nail. Joey Pazia, the last two times he's carried the ball, has been the hammer. And I got to say, Big John Bowler leading the way with some aggressive play, the junior offensive lineman.
Here's Pazzi over the left-hand side, pushes forward close to the first down. Let's see if they give it to him.
John Bowen.
Well, we got Bowler on our mind. Basketball's coming up. Practice starts Monday for the Spy Ponders. They're looking to compete for a state title.
Some high hopes for the
very for the, high for hopes the Ponders. There, and high hopes for the girls basketball team, which on January 8th will play at the Boston Garden.
Wow!
So there you go.
Wow! Good, lucky for them, they're playing indoors.
Yeah. So here's Varney throwing up a little duck intended there for Cully Curran, gonna bring up a 4th and 1.
You know, we got a really nice crowd out to see this.
Beautiful crowd
today.
Out here on a frigid Turkey Day. Gobble, gobble. Happy Thanksgiving to you and yours from all of us here at ACMI.
We laughed. The requests for shout outs are coming flooding into the booth.
They are. And here over the right hand side goes Pazzi, but he drops the football and it's full and it's pounced on by a Cougar. That's Michael Burke on defense falling on the fumble.
Oh, let's see what happened here. It looked like at the exchange he never really had full control of the ball, was carrying it low, and when his arm got stripped, the ball just kind of fell harmlessly to the ground. Too bad for Pazia. The super sophomore getting a taste of rivalry game football on the last game of the year. It's going to be a nice way for him to go into the offseason.
It sure is. So 9:32 left in the ball game. The Cougars will take over deep in their own territory. Berg is actually in the end zone. Here's a little.
Oh!
Look, it's intercepted! Colin Curran into the end zone for his second touchdown of the day. And a bing, and a bang, and a boom. And gobble, gobble.
Wow, I tell you that the Cougars went to that little play to the left one too many times, it looks like. That time it was sniffed out by Curran, who made a sharp play by putting his hands up in the passing lane. Ball hit Curran's hands, and he was able to kind of come up with it. Great play by Curran, and the tables turn very, very quickly here in the fourth quarter.
Very quickly, and so Swift will try the extra point. He's been perfect today. See if I jinxed him. The kick is up, and the kick is good, and with 9:27 left in the game for the Spy Ponders in the career, high school career for the seniors, they jump out to the Spy Ponders due to a 28-0 lead. And Rob, this is the time of the game when we usually start to turn our focus to seniors. We talked with John Solomon at halftime, who was a member of the 1995 championship game, and off the tip of his tongue, he could rattle off 10 to 12 names of fellow combatants that he played with back in the day, and it'll be the same for these seniors.
Yeah, absolutely, and the seniors have shown a lot of leadership, and the seniors that have been important to this team, Captain Michael Thielbar, big senior Ben Jacy. We'll talk more.
Yeah, and Riley Donovan goes over the 30 to the 32 on the return, and that's where the Cougars will take over first and 10. And Rob, talk to me, tell me a little more about, we talked a lot last night, we've talked a lot in the broadcast all season, of the importance of the senior leadership on the Spy Ponders.
Well, the seniors, I mean, this is really their season, and these are the guys coming into the year who knows what it's like to play on the varsity football field, and it's really been up to them to make sure that this team, you know, kind of keeps its head in the game, even as they've had some kind of tough games as the season has progressed. And they've ended the year with 3 straight wins, so that's a testament to the fact that nobody quit and the seniors led, as we see a big play here by the Cougars.
Yeah, and Spencer Burton certainly hasn't quit as he stumbles, bumbles, and mumbles his way near the 50-yard line. And the Cougars, Rob, in the same boat, the same type of a team. The majority of their players are underclassmen. They do have seniors, and they have seniors who have led well. We were talking with Coach Clivio game, and here's Burke as Burke takes the ball over the left-hand side for a nice little gain. And he was talking that Nico Fernandez, coach, offensive tackle, defensive end, has been a tremendous leader for the Cougars this year. So 2nd and 5.
Right on cue, Fernandez, coach, the right tackle. Blows a big hole, pushes his way out a few yards, and brings up 3rd and short.
And then you see Cordell Parrish at the top of your screen, a wide receiver. He's a senior for the Cougars as they face a 3rd and 3 Clock roll coming up on 8 minutes left in the Thanksgiving Day Classic. Here's Burke, a nice little spiral. He's got a man. The ball is caught at the 15. Goes Michael Stanford on a beautiful throw from Michael Burke.
Nice throw from Burke. Let's see this again. Lays it out there, and the ball hits the receiver, and then two defenders collapse and push the ball right into his chest. I think it's going to have to be surgically removed there, and we have a call on the Ponders after the play. Looks like a 15-yard. They're going to call some kind of a unsportsmanlike conduct penalty there,
yeah,
or unnecessary roughness.
Yeah, I don't think the Stripes likes how Arlington is conducting themselves, and you know, we're on the field. I can honestly say I don't see anything up here in the booth, but
yeah,
certainly that's the third roughing or unsportsmanlike penalty during the contest, and we've had a player ejected from the ball game.
Yeah, they're sending a message to the Ponders, you know, clean it up, boys. There's no question about it. They're protecting the Cougars a little bit. The Cougars are down 28-0. It might have started with a little bit of showmanship by Cully Curran, who's had a wonderful football game, but kind of backed into the end zone, walked backwards 5 yards just before halftime, and the game started to get chippy at about that point.
Yeah, it sure did. And but you know, as we both said up here, that was the most exciting play of the year, and
yeah,
you know, that's
that is football. This is varsity athletics.
It's football in the year 2016. These are millennial athletes, and you know, I don't know what people expect them to do. So you know, I enjoyed it, and so we'll move on. So first and goal for the Cougars, who are looking to punch one in here with 7:41 left in the contest. Burke on a run pass option. He throws it and just gets rid of it, as good coverage downfield by the Spy Ponders. And the secondary, Rob, as you said, they've been much improved and they've had a nice day today.
Secondary, I got to be honest with you, Scott. Earlier in the season, I thought that the unit that needed the most work was the secondary of the Spy Ponders. And it's turned a weakness of the football team, perhaps, has turned into one of the real strengths of the football team. And we're seeing it today.
Second and goal. So here's Burton over the right-hand side. Plows his way into the end zone. Spencer Burton with bad intentions and scores a touchdown. Gobble, gobble.
Burton, big 220-pound Spencer Burton, just puts his shoulder down.
Woo!
And bowls into the end
Woo!
Zone. Yeah, that was a feat of strength right
Wow.
there. Wow! Nice play, and it's nice to see the Cougars get in the end zone, and on this senior last day for the seniors for that football squad.
So Matt Hanley to try the extra point. The kick is up, and the kick is good. And with 7:29 left in the ball game, the Spy Ponders lead 28-7, and Rob. You know, we've had some unsportsmanlike penalties called against the Spy Ponders, and I got to point out to you, because we saw a game last year which we called the game of the century, where the Spy Ponders scored, I don't know, it was 21 points in 5 or 6 minutes or so, and this game isn't over. It's just not.
Yeah, game's not over. 7:29, I was just looking at the score. So we probably will expect an onside kick from the Cougars here, and the Ponders are talking about that. We'll likely see for them what would be called the hands team. The Ponders will put receivers and running backs up at the line of scrimmage, and it looks like they're gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 players on the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
So they're expecting an onside
yep,
kick.
Yep, and El Yunsi is the only deep back here. They're definitely expecting an onside kick. Now the kick has to go 10 yards before it can be touched by the uh, by the white team. That's why they're not touching it. The ball be placed dead. Well, actually, that's going to be a foul if he touches it. Well, they actually, they whistled it dead. So they whistle it dead right there, and the Spy Ponders will take over first and 10 at the Cougar 47-yard line on Thanksgiving. Again, ACMI, all of us at ACMI want to wish all of you at home a happy Thanksgiving. Hope that turkey is just starting to get nice and crisp and juicy in the oven. And just as we're getting a bit frozen here at Pierce Field, hopefully everything's roasty toasty home for you and yours. First and 10. Here is my man. There goes Joey Pazia over the left-hand side.
Uh-oh.
To the 19-yard line. Flag on the play.
And that's going to come back. They're going to call
that's
a hold.
That's a hold. And I got to tell you something, Rob, and you can tell me if I'm misreading the situation. These officials are angry at the Spy Ponders. Am I misreading that? No,
you use the word bad intent. We certainly don't know, but the pattern of the flags would suggest that.
Yeah, I mean, we don't know. It is a guess of mine, but you know, I'm putting 1 and 1 and 3 and 5 together.
And getting 10.
Right. 1, 1, 3, 5.
Well, you know, player ejected, and this is what, this fifth or sixth. Big play that's come back.
Yeah, and over the left-hand side, there goes.
Well, that was Pazia.
My man Pazia. Pazia has come in. We've seen Nascimento go down with an injury. We've seen Woods get disqualified from this contest. And Pazia now has come in, and he's shown very worthy of the task. Lots of long runs. He did fumble the football, but on the next play, Cully Curran intercepted a pass for a touchdown to give the Spy Ponders at that time a 28-0 lead. So Varney's going to pass, and the ball is caught by Al Yunsi, and have a game, Adam, Al Yunsi.
Yeah, and Keenan Varney also fired that right into the right spot. Timing play, and here comes Adam Bowler back into the ball game. So they're going to let Adam Bowler finish out the season here. He was limping. He's limping a little bit.
He was. I am actually shocked he's back in this football game, but I think that the score has a lot to do with it. 28-7. Clock rolls coming up on 5:35 left in the contest. Here goes Pazzi over the right-hand side. He slips a tackle down to the 20, the 18, rolls Joey Pazia.
Wow.
Bang, bang, boom for Pazia.
Quick hitter by Pazia. That happened so fast. Look at that. Just fires right through the hole. Happened so fast the Stripes couldn't even get a flag out of their pocket in time. Surprised everybody.
Oh, they hit my funny bunk in one part. So the clock will stop here with 5:13 left in the contest. And Rob, I want to tell you a little bit about something else going on that Athletic Mr. Dugucki told me about. And that's that. So I told you that on January 8th, the girls' basketball will be playing at the Garden, Arlington High girls' basketball. On the 11th, the boys' hockey team will be at Frozen Fenway.
Is that right?
That is right, Frozen Fenway.
That is super exciting.
That is one place I will not be on the 11th of January. I will be someplace indoors and warm, but I'm sure the boys will be having a wonderful time down there.
What a great experience.
What a great experience, though. What a wonderful, super-duper experience for the Spy Ponder hockey team.
Congratulations to Melissa Dugalecki for arranging that. I'm sure that a lot of kind of hard work went into that.
No doubt. She's done a bang-up job here at Arlington. Here's Pazzi over the right-hand side. This time he's stopped up by Matthew Morangetti with a help from a couple of other angry Cougars, and that's a loss. Brings up a second and 12. Clock rolls. We're under 5 minutes left in the contest here.
You know, it's nice seeing Pazzi. It's always great to have a versatile running attack, and looking forward for the Ponders. You know, John Nascimento emerged as a kind of a between the tackles runner this year, and Pazzi is showing some of that potential today. And, you know, as we know, Adam Bowler is a run pass threat. Elijah Woods coming back.
So over the middle, the pass is caught! Michael Doherty, there's my man! Bing, bang, boom!
And it's coming back.
It is coming back. There comes your flag.
Wow.
They're going to say an illegal formation on the spy Ponders.
Legal procedure?
Legal procedure.
It would be great to get another look at that if we can. Do we have a replay? Do we have a replay of that? Not sure.
If we can.
Not sure that we do, but that time they're calling it illegal procedure. Coach Genrin, he's hot. He's on the field saying, you know, kind of what's going on here.
Yeah. Well, I have a little bit of a theory of what's going on here. And, well, we've talked about this before. I'm debating on whether I really should touch on this.
Maybe not, because we don't know. We did catch ourselves last week.
Yeah.
Missing a hold that we complained about.
Yeah.
I mean, we can see what's happening here.
So here's Pazzi over the left-hand side, and a nice play there by Spencer Burton. And Spencer Burton's had a day. And, you know, I'll just say this, Rob, that sometimes when games get lopsided, officials don't like to see them get more lopsided.
Yeah.
And so I'm – maybe that's happening here.
Yeah.
Maybe not. Who knows? So
That'd be a strong guess.
So we'll move on. And so we're coming up on 3:25 left in the ball game. 3rd and 15 for the Spy Ponders. Pazzi, the deep back. He's had a wonderful Thanksgiving. He's going to eat and sleep well today, as will myself and partner. Here's a flag here. Another delay game against the Spy Ponders.
Yeah.
So
if they're angry, they're angry at all these kind of shivering cold fans who are pulled up.
Yeah.
Watching the game, hoping that the clock will roll a little bit.
So we're coming up on 3 minutes left in the game, and it's going to be 3rd and California for the Spy Ponders. They're going to throw the ball. Going back to that matchup, it was intended for Doherty.
I tell you, Adam Bowler got pasted.
Actually, it's intended for, Elyounce.
Bowler got pasted as he delivered that ball. And what a season it's been for Adam Bowler. Came in as a sophomore, his very first games, getting a feel for varsity action, and here he is on Thanksgiving Day tossing a strike towards the end zone, and while he's getting hit. And I guess the freshman team was undefeated this year for the Ponders, and the
10-0.
Junior varsity team was 8-2. All the underclassmen coming back for them.
So there's a little pitch and a little catch that time. A little pitch and a little catch. Bowler to Pickett. And Pickett's a senior. So the Cougars will take over on downs. And so, you know, with 2:34 on Thanksgiving, we're going to talk seniors now. Senior Michael Theobar. Senior Ben Jacy. Senior Matt Pickett. Senior Ryan Mathers, senior James Bradley, senior Michael Mazzy, senior Michael Doherty, senior John Nascimento, for the Spy Ponders, and we'll tell you who the seniors are on the Arlington Cougars after this play. Here's Burke handing off to Spencer Burton, who's tripped up after a gain of two. For the Spy Ponders, Cordell Senior, Kiernan Mullen Senior, Michael Kallenberg Senior, Danny Marr Senior, Nick Wansa Senior, Shane Fitzgerald. So I just actually gave you the juniors, folks. So, can't let that one go. So,
baby, it's cold outside.
Baby, it's cold outside. So that's the junior lineup for the Spy Ponders.
We even have brain freeze going on.
Coming back next year. So third and three for Burke. He falls for the first down. Let's try this again.
Reset. Reset.
Senior Jackson Smith, Senior Seamus Holden, Senior Spencer Burton, Senior Matt Piggott, Senior Eric Spagnoli, Senior Connor Keenan, Senior Nico Fernandez Coat, Senior Quentin Pasquarello. And I think I got all the seniors there for the Cougars. And a nice little pass here to Spencer Burton. We can get a replay of that. I hope we can get a replay of that. What a nice little play that was as the clock winds down to a minute left.
Here we go. Oh, a pass. I didn't actually see the play. I was auditing your call of the seniors. I haven't seen a play like that at football at any level. You know, Burton was as surprised as anybody to see the ball tossed back to him. But, you know, kind of charge forward, knew what to do with it. And this time we have a flag going against the Cougars.
109 against the Cougars, down 28-7. So
you didn't call quite enough seniors here. We have senior. We have perhaps a senior moment that time by Stripes.
So first and 10, here's Burke running for his life. He's taken down by Michael Thielbar. What a wow. Day, what a career, what a way to end your career by Thielbar.
Wow, good fitting end to the he's making getting every last drop of juice out of his high school football career. The last play in the Coach Gendron, classy move by taking Thielbar out. Congratulations to Thielbar, and his coaches are congratulating, his teammates are congratulating him. Really been a star of this football team. Kind of the heart, the soul, the center. He, along with Big Ben Jacy, John Bowen, Ryan Mathers, Matt Pickett. Can't say enough about all those guys.
Those were kind of the heart and soul, kind of the foundation, the bedrock of the team. And they stuck with it. They led the team. They were and here we get a sack here, a nice sack by the Spy Ponders. Clock will stop with 56 seconds left in the game as Arlington Catholic will call a timeout. And Rob, you really have to say for the Spy Ponders, they turned the season around.
They absolutely
did. There's no other way to paint it.
Well, and congratulations to Coach Genrin. We said some nice things about Coach Clivio and absolutely meant it in the first half. Coach Genrin's done a really fine job kind of keeping the enthusiasm, very positive coach, and keeping the enthusiasm high on this football team. You know, they were 0-8. They easily could have quit on each other, quit on the season. And they kept on coming to practice, practicing hard, coming to games, pumped up. And so nice to see him break through and see it all pay off, ending the season with three big wins in a row.
Big wins in a row. Here's Burke. A little pitch and a little catch that time to Cordell Parrish, who falls forward. And, Rob, just to piggyback on what you were saying, I don't think I've ever met a coach with a more positive, a genuine positive attitude than Coach Gendron. And I was telling him last night that that game we did here, and you can find it on YouTube at the ACMI channel against Wilmington, when the game was over and the players all sprinted to the A on the in the middle of the field, that I found it almost impossible to believe that that was a team that was 1-8 at the time. And that what the players had to say after the game and how positive they were and the glowing way they spoke about not only the senior leadership, but the leadership and positivity of the coaches. I think it speaks volumes about what Gendron is doing and the program he's building here.
Yeah, the team's responded well to him. And, you know, I saw Remember the Titans again this week, wonderful movie, and there's this great line, attitude reflects leadership. And I think that's what we've seen here for the Ponders.
I agree. 4th and 12 for Serge Clivio and his team with 46 seconds left in the Thanksgiving Day game for the year 2016. Here's Burke. He's going to go deep. He's got a man. It was intended for Cordell Parrish. It falls harmlessly incomplete, and the Spy Ponders will be able to take the ball over 1st and 10 at the AC 32. Victory formation and able to drink the sweet juices of a Thanksgiving Day victory.
Oh, that was quite poetic there, Scott. The sweet juices of a Thanksgiving.
Sweet juices.
Are you kind of salivating, thinking of the turkey to come?
I am, yes.
Of the dark meat
of
that you're
going to? Of a basted turkey, the golden crisp outing, but the moist center of a turkey heaped with mashed potatoes and all the fixings.
Wow. I'm thankful to hear about all that. We'll be having Thanksgiving dinner tonight together. Looking forward to that, as always.
We will, as been the tradition since we started broadcasting this Thanksgiving Day game. And so sophomore Adam Bowler takes a knee. He's going to have to do it one more time, and that'll wrap things up here. We hope to have some interviews post-game with players and coaches, and we will have the coverage of the post-game award ceremony, and that'll do it. And so the final score on Thanksgiving Day 2016, the Arlington Spy Ponders 28, the Arlington Catholic Cougars 7. For Rob Anthony, I'm Scott Zwick. We want to wish you a happy Thanksgiving. And before we get on, because we're live here, and before we get on to the award ceremony, and Rob, as you know, can you explain to us how the award ceremony goes for the...
Well, they meet at midfield. It's a wonderful tradition here where each team... nominates a player of the game for the opposing team. So it is active sportsmanship following a game that, quite frankly, got a little bit chippy, and we'll see if some wounds can be healed by what is a really kind of a nice tradition after the ball game with the award ceremony.
Wonderful tradition. So we're going to continue our tradition here now, and we're going to name our ACMI players of the game. So we're going to each have a choice. So there's going to be two players from each team. So I'm going to give you a second to collect your thoughts because I'm kind of springing this on you. So I'm going to go give my pick first. I'm going to go with we're going to start with Arlington Catholic, okay? And my Arlington Catholic player of the game is going to be Spencer Burton, okay? That run into the end zone, pounding it in there was – as hard a hit on offense that I've seen all year long. And so he gets a bing, bang, boom from me and the player of the game. Rob, who was your ACMI player of the game for the Arlington Catholic Cougars?
I'm going to go with Michael Burke and the quarterback. Michael Burke did a real nice job. And as the game game progressed, he was, hitting a lot of those balls out to the short left and moving his squad down the football field, and really hung in there very nicely while under intense pressure much of the ball game. Michael Burke is my call for player of the game.
So for the Spot Bonders, I'm going to go with Adamel Yunsi, the junior wide receiver. And so we'll speed this up here. And who's your pick going to be?
Cully Curran
is going to be your pick, and that's a good selection there. And so now we are, as we see the two teams going to midfield, we are going to join the post-game celebration. Ceremony. So there we have the wide shot of the ceremony. Some kind words are being said there as each team gave out the Player of the Game Award. The Arlington Catholic players choose the award for the Arlington High players. The Arlington High players choose the award for the Arlington Catholic players, and so for Arlington Catholic, Spencer Burton got the award, and for Arlington High School, Cully Curran got the award. So,
can Rob hear me right now?
Partner, can you hear me? I cannot hear him. Do I even know where he is? Partner, can you hear me? I don't think he's wearing his headsets, fellas.
He's not. Yeah, he's not.
All right, so while we have a second here, we'll go over the scoring recap. Scoring started with Woods in a 12-yard run with 4:07 in the first. The extra point was good. A 90-yard pass from Bowler to Curran with 8:07 left in the second made it 14-0. That was our score at the half for the Spy Bonders. The second half, Varney to El Yunsi with 9:53 in the third made it 21-0. Then Cully Curran with a 4-yard interception with 9:27 left in the fourth made it a 28-0 game, and then the Arlington Catholic got on the board with a 4-yard touchdown run by Spencer Burton with 7:29 left in the contest, and that was our final score. The Spy Ponders went on to win 28-7, and let's see if my partner Rob, can you hear me, partner?
Yes, I can. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Fantastic.
So I'm not sure if you were able to catch the ceremony. So Spencer Burton got the award from the Arlington High players, and Cully Curran got the award from the Arlington Catholic players. So
Much deserved for both players.
Much deserved for both players, and you said maybe a little bit of healing might be done, and certainly the selection of Curran would suggest that that definitely might have taken place in the post game.
Yeah, they acknowledged Curran's great play on both sides of the football. Got in the end zone with a big 62-yard or a big 90-yard catch, as well as a 4-yard interception, pick six. So big day for Mr. Curran. And again, you know, we talked about the season turning for the Ponders and ending with 3 straight wins, and they started playing well really when Cully Curran came back and added that spark to the team.
He sure did add that spark to the team, and a player who we didn't really mention much today, but you know, I talked about him all year, and I just thought he was the heart and soul of this team, and the player that just showed the love of football, especially when things weren't going very well. And that was my man Michael Doherty. I thought he represented everything that you want out of a football player, and I just couldn't be more impressed with his performance in general this season, Rob.
There's no question about that. And you know, we've harped on this theme of leadership. There weren't – how many seniors are really on this Ponder football team? Really 5 or 6, right? Just 5 or 6 seniors? But every single one of them really stepped up and had kind of a monster year. And those seniors are going to be – you know, a lot of talent going forward for the Ponders. But each one of these seniors is going to have big shoes to fill. And Michael Doherty, big shoes to fill in terms of both his pass catching ability, but also, and his chemistry with Adam Bowler, but also just the kind of heart that he brought to the football team.
No doubt about his heart. And you know, we certainly talked about the seniors, and rightfully so, on a Thanksgiving day where we honor our seniors and where it's most memorable of the seniors. But for the Spy Ponders, the legacy the seniors will have will be that they will be passing on to a team that's largely made up of underclassmen. You know, looking down the list, Colin Curry is a junior. El Yunsi is a junior. Adam Bowler is a sophomore. Joey Pazia is a sophomore. Sam Swift is a sophomore.
Elijah Woods
is a junior. So, I mean, these are key players coming back for next year, and the future's bright for the Spy Ponders.
Yeah, it certainly is. I think the question, Scott, will be size, losing Ben Jacy and Michael Thielbar, who held down the middle of the football field and on defense and on offense, always gave Adam Bowler a lot of time. So the good news about that is size is, to a certain extent, something that you can do something about over the offseason. And, you know, if you're a sophomore or junior on this team, you know, it's time to get in the weight room and bulk up, because that's what this football team is going to need next year. The skill positions have, you know, a lot of returning talent, but you're going to miss some beef in the middle.
There certainly is an opportunity there for one of several of the players, probably players that were playing on the junior varsity or maybe even the freshman team, to step in and take those roles. And you know, we again, coming back to that word meritocracy, you know, kind of wrapping everything together from the beginning of the year to the end of the year, you know, with it being a meritocracy. And you see Joey Pazzia running today, and you know, you see junior Keenan Varney come in and throw an 80-yard touchdown pass, and yeah, I don't think nobody's going to come in to the off season saying to themselves, "Geez, I can just take it easy. I got a starting job all sewn up." Right?
Yeah, nobody will. You know, it's interesting. We're old-timers here, Scott. We were 4 or 5 years ago. Remember the phrase unfinished business. The Potters came into the year using the phrase unfinished business. And, this season, there's kind of a yin and a yang to it if you're the Potters. Ended the season on a high, 3 straight wins. We felt good about this football team all year long, and there certainly we're talking about all the talent that's coming back next year. At the same time, it was a 3-win season, and so if you're an underclassman for the Potters, you got to feel like there is something to prove next year, and you're going to certainly want to work for that as the Potters come charging out to midfield from their huddle in the end zone. In a display of family for a team that has really rallied as a family this year, and that's been one of the watchwords for the Ponders.
Sure has been one of the watchwords. Guys, can we get a shot of the Spy Ponders here at holding the trophy up? I hope we can. I really hope. There we go. And that's what it's all about, folks. That's what Turkey Day is all about, raising that trophy up. That's what they fight for. Spy Ponders have won 5 contests. The Arlington Catholic Cougars have won 4. The Arlington Catholic Cougars dominated this series early, and it's been the Spy Ponders dominating of late, winning 4 in a row. The Arlington Catholic Cougars won 4 of the first 5, and so it's 5-4 in favor of the Spy Ponders. And so, Rob, you know, I mean, this is a big win for the Spy Ponders, taking 5-4 lead in the series.
Yeah, always. So they've got bragging rights for another year, and they've got to feel good about that. And these guys, and we say this every year, but they grow up playing on the playgrounds, Pop Warner football with the Arlington Catholic Cougars. And, this win today feels extra sweet.
It sure does. And I got to ask you, is it a little chilly down there in the field, or is it I see the sun's almost poking out.
I got to tell you, it's probably pushing 40 now. It's feeling okay. I
was feeling able okay.
To take off my hat. There's no sting in my eyes.
Oh, there you go.
We're ready for some interviews.
Well, what was the year? Was it 2 years ago when it was 25 and the wind was whipping at about 30 miles an hour?
Those were the days. The snow on the field. Don't miss that.
No, not at all. Not at all.
Okay.
So coming over to you now is Coach Clivio, and that is number 2, Spencer Burton, who got into the end zone.
Yeah, we're ready for you. Fantastic. Step right up, Coach. Are we live?
We are live. We're ready to go.
Let me take off my gloves here to shake the coach's hand. Hard-fought game today. We got to get you a headphone, however. Here we go.
Stretch that out a little.
Let us know, Scott, if you can hear Coach. Coach, no, if you can.
How's that, okay?
Yeah,
that's good.
Yeah, that's perfect. Perfect.
Yeah, yeah, we're good. And this is head coach Serge Clivio. Hard-fought game today, Coach. Couldn't quite find the formula.
Yeah, the we had some good drives early, and then we went backwards. Penalties, penalties and a couple of sacks, matched us. Backwards, we got inside the 10 early and didn't score. That really was a killer, I think, not doing that. And then they came up with some big, huge plays. They had a couple of good drives, but then they hit a couple of big plays that really, put the knife in the back. And, as I said, it was a good physical game. Most of the time, they made the big plays, you know, and we didn't. So that was the big difference. You know?
The big plays mattered. It did seem to be a very hard-hitting football game. Got a little chippy there in the second half.
Yeah, I think you're always going to get chippy in a game. It's not just Thanksgiving game, but when you play in a, you know, that I say true school, one town, a lot of these kids know each other, you're always going to have some of that chippiness, you know, and some of that, you know, some of that stuff going on. So, it gets a little chippy. You try to stay focused on the football part, but kids get emotional and, you know, but as I said, you know, it was good, hard-fought, physical game. You like to see the kids, you know, playing physical and playing hard. But as I said, they just came up with big plays, you know, and that was the real difference.
And senior Spencer Burton here, whom we will talk to, delivered the wood on his touchdown, speaking of physical play.
Yeah. Spencer's a physical player, you know, a good physical running back, you know, a physical linebacker. You know, he brings hard hitting, and, you know, when he runs physically, he had trouble getting going. They were obviously being very physical up front and dominating our line early in the game, and we had a lot of trouble getting Spencer moving and going. So, you know, we try to move the ball outside, you know, a little bit, and then come back into Spencer, and then, you know, he finally got a few good runs. You know, and when he runs, he tends to put a little hit into the run. So
yes. Okay, well, thanks for joining us here, Coach. Good to see you, and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Okay, Professor, up next we got, this is Seamus Holden, wide receiver.
Okay, that's good. We've got Seamus Holden with us, wide receiver, and Spencer Burton, congratulations on a hard fought football game today. Couldn't quite get it done, but you know, looked like there was a lot of hitting going on out there today, and some fun was had. Talk about the game.
Can't hear.
Gonna have to put the.
Can't hear.
Okay, we're gonna need no, can't hear. Gonna need the headset.
There we go.
We'll start with you,
Seamus Holden.
Seamus, excuse me. So you're talking about the fact that you grew up playing against these guys. What's it like? Talk about what it's like to be back on the field with them on the other side of the ball.
I mean, it's really crazy because 10 years ago, I played my first game here, and then 10 years later, I'm playing my last game here against the kids that I grew up playing with. So it's really crazy seeing them on the other side of the ball.
Yeah. And you're a wide receiver. How did the cold affect the play today?
Honestly, my adrenaline was just I couldn't even tell that it was cold today. Just
right.
One question each.
Okay, fantastic. So let's hear from Spencer Burton, Big Spencer. Looked like a rock'em sock'em game today, Spencer, and you delivered a lot of the blows, got in the end zone. Congratulations. Talk a little bit about the ball game.
Well, like Seamus said, and like Coach Livio said, they're a tough team up front. One of the best front four I think we've played all year. And we've played St. Mary's, good teams that are still making their runs in the Super Bowl. So our line just couldn't hold up. We got a lot of sophomores that are going to rise up and step to the occasion next year, I hope, and bring some wins back.
Awesome. Well, you fought hard, and you've got the look of a football player after a hard-fought game. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
All right, well done, Professor. So we will now hopefully move on to the Spy Ponders. And that certainly was a heck of a run there by Spencer Burton, one of the toughest touchdown runs we saw this year, don't you think?
I think no question. And standing next to Spencer, you can see where his strength comes from. He's got really stout legs, really trees down there, and you can see where he's going to be a load to bring down. Wouldn't want to be on the receiving end of one of those blows. And that was a nice compliment for the Ponders, talking about the fact that the Ponders are one of the best front fours that they've played all year, and they play in a very tough kind of Catholic division. That's a lot to say.
And this is 65 Ben Jacy right here.
Hey, Ben, congratulations. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
On a big win and a hard-fought football game.
Yeah, definitely.
So Spencer Burton just said that you guys were the toughest front four he's played against all year. That's quite a compliment.
Yeah. Well, I personally don't play. I didn't play defense this game, but I'm still part of the. I do all the drills with them, and we just go hard in practice all the time. Just relentless. We're always just hitting heads and crashing into each other. It's fun. It's a fun time, but. We just work really hard.
Okay, fantastic. Well, it paid off today.
Yep.
Good work and happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Michael Theobrage coming in next.
Big Michael Thielbar, happy Thanksgiving, and I want to say congratulations on a really fine senior campaign and a tough football game today.
Yeah, it was. You know, we practiced hard all week. We showed up, big plays. Great game.
Spent a lot of time in the backfield of the Cougars. Got penetration early. What was the key?
Well, you know, I just gotta grab onto him and let my other teammates make plays. Gotta get in the backfield and my linebackers make plays. Everybody make plays.
Fantastic. Well, that's certainly what happened today. And once again, congratulations on a great football career.
Thank
here.
You.
Okay.
John Bowen is coming in next.
Okay, Big John Bowen. Here you go, Mr. Bowen. So it got a little chippy out there, Mr. Bowen, today, and you were kind of wielding that stump of a right arm. Talk about the atmosphere of the football game.
Well, football is definitely a very competitive sport. And it shows on the field how we really get into it. And at the end of the game, though, we're all still good friends and everything outside of the field. But when we're on the field, it's definitely a battle till the end. And what you got to do, you know. But, yeah, it's tough with the arm.
Yeah.
I made it work, though.
Well, congratulations. Our interviews with the Cougars, there were a lot of congratulations for the strength of the Ponder team, and we certainly agree.
Yeah. Well, it's all in the off season. Like, we work hard. We condition hard. And we had a tough season, but we never gave up. And, I mean, being a winning team is easy, but being a losing team is a lot harder. But we stuck it through, worked hard, and the outcome is what we wanted.
Okay. Well, congratulations and happy Thanksgiving to you.
Thank you.
The rest of the team. You might want to head out and grab a piece of that group photo. Okay, coach will be here in a bit, Scott.
Well, you know, this gives us a little bit of time to thank our crew, produced by Staz Modrzynski and Sundar Rajan, and you have with you Coach Gendron.
Hey, Coach.
All right.
Congratulations and happy Thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Hard-fought football game today, and you came out on top.
Yeah, that was a great game. I don't think it was as far apart as the score looked. You know, AC was a tough team. We had a couple big plays that put points on the board quickly, but there were times when we couldn't move it against them. They were a tough team.
The physical football game. The Cougars were saying that you guys were the toughest interior team they played against all year. Nice compliment from them.
Yeah, it was a great compliment, especially because that's been, you know, these post-game meetings, we've been talking about how we, although it might be outsized, we're really preaching toughness to those guys inside. And I think we really saw it, especially as the game wore on. That toughness didn't go away, so I was pleased with those guys.
So the big play, the 90-yard touchdown pass from Bowler, and then the to Cully Curran,
yeah.
And then the 62-yarder from Keenan Varney to Elianuisi. Then Bowler got in the end zone again,
yeah.
Or Curran got in the end zone again on the pick six. Talk about those guys and the big plays.
Man. So first the quarterbacks. I mean, we talked about this early in the year how it was back and forth all preseason who would the starter would be. And it was that way all year, too. You know, Varney put together, he played mostly in those JV games. JV went 8-2, in large part thanks to him slinging the ball around. So when Bowler got a little dinged up, we weren't worried. You know, we preached team, and we preached that we got lots of other guys who can contribute if someone gets hurt, and that's what we saw. The receivers definitely helped them out. Adam Elianuisi had a huge game. Cully had a great game. Pickett had a good game. Doherty. I thought he caught a touchdown that mysteriously came back.
Yes.
You know, so just all over the place you saw plays being made.
Well, that's great. So let's look forward a little bit, Coach. You had a young team. You got a lot of skill position players coming back. End of the season with some momentum. Three big wins going into the offseason.
Yeah.
How you feeling about this football team going forward?
We're excited, and we knew that the growing pains would be tough, and they were. But now that you're on the other side of it, it's, you know, you can't trade or buy that experience for those young guys and playing a whole season of football when they're sophomores or juniors. Now they're back with some experience, some confidence, some meanness, and I really like where things are headed.
Excellent. Well, congratulations for keeping the enthusiasm high, keeping the family together. And speaking of family, happy Thanksgiving.
Thanks.
And
you
congratulations.
Yeah, yeah. And the last thing I'd say is that I didn't keep anything together. Really, it was those seniors that you just talked to who at week 8 were 0-8. They're not slouching. They're not moping around. They're keeping that tempo and the expectations high. So I think this is a great way to send them out and reward them for their faith, even when things were looking a little shaky.
Very difficult to do. Just a great achievement.
Yeah, great. All right, thank you guys all year for your coverage up top, and you guys out.
Happy
cold.
Thanksgiving,
Appreciate
Coach.
Appreciate it, Scott. All right, great job up there. All right, thank you very much.
All right, so long.
All right.
Awesome. So we're gonna wrap things up here. First, we want to thank our wonderful crew. We've had. I gotta say, I just really have to say, it's the best crew we've had since I've been here at ACMI. The producers were Staz, Modrzynski, and Sundar Rajan. Camera one was Felix Ansell and Andrew Wilson. Camera two, Ben Hickey. Camera three, Jillian Petrillo. Camera four, Lucas Delbanco and Matthew Chan. Audio, Colin Gilbert. Crunch Mike, Varun Gopal, director Sundar Rajan, camera four Sundar Rajan, also engineer Super Staz, engineered Jeff Munro, who can be found staff at ACMI, graphics Samuel Kim, and Samuel was responsible for the wonderful graphic you saw at the beginning at our YouTube channel. Graphic creation of Samuel Kim, Megan O'Brien, and replay was Andrew Wilson, Felix Ansell. Our final here on Thanksgiving Day 2016, the Arlington Spyponders take it 28-7. For Rob Anthony, I'm Scott Zwick, saying happy Thanksgiving to you and yours. Have a wonderful off season, and we'll see you opening day 2017. Bing, bang, boom.